You came to work on Friday. Is it fair to say that you had no idea you'd be press secretary at the end of the day?
I certainly don't think that was part of the original plan, waking up and getting ready to go to work on Friday. But I'm honored to be here and excited to continue being part of the president's team and helping continue to get his message out there, and honored to do it.
I wonder how you see your role. You know, Sean Spicer, your predecessor, seemed to get hammered from both sides. The president complained that he wasn't tough enough. The press complained that he wasn't transparent and truthful enough. How will you strike the balance?
I think anytime, usually if the press is attacking you in this situation, you're probably doing something right. I think Sean did a tremendous job. He's very loyal, served the president admirably. And, you know, again, I'm looking forward to being part of the president's team to continue pushing out his message. We want to talk about jobs and health care and how we can make America great again. And that's our focus, and that's what we're going to come to work every day and try to do.
I want to ask you the same question John Carl asked Sean Spicer on his first day. Do you promise to always try to tell the truth from that podium?
Absolutely, and not just to you, but I think that's our duty. Certainly, I have three young kids, and I want to be able to go home and look my kids in the eye every single day, and that's far more important to me to be able to do that and have that the highest level of honesty and integrity. And I want to do that not just in my job, but in every single thing I do. And so this is just an extension of me being able to do that, and I'm excited and honored to do it.
Let's move on to some of the big issues of the week. The House and the Senate seem to have come to an agreement yesterday on a bill with tough sanctions for Russia. It also restricts the president's ability to lift those sanctions, add sanctions for Iran and North Korea. Will the president sign that bill?
Look, the administration is supportive of being tough on Russia, particularly in putting these sanctions in place. The original piece of legislation was poorly written, but we were able to work with the House and Senate, and the administration is happy with the ability to do that and make those changes that were necessary. And we support where the legislation is now, and we'll continue working with the House and Senate to put those tough sanctions in place on Russia until the situation in Ukraine is fully resolved, and it certainly isn't right now.
So the president will sign that bill. That's a little news right there. I want to move on now to the Attorney General, Jeff Sessions. As you know, the president in a New York Times interview was very tough on the Attorney General this week, said he would never have appointed him had he known he was going to recuse himself from the Russia investigation, said that was unfair to the president. A new issue cropped up in the Washington Post over the weekend. Reports that an intelligence intercept showed that the Attorney General did indeed talk with the Russian ambassador about the campaign. The president responded to that in a tweet. He said, a new intelligence leak from the Amazon Washington Post, this time against AG Jeff Sessions. These illegal leaks, like Comey's, must stop. That appears to be a confirmation that the Attorney General was indeed talking to the Russian ambassador about the campaign.
I don't think so at all, Georgia. I completely disagree. I think the president's point is that there's a real problem with leaks. Whether they're actual leaks or not, there's an issue that there are constant stories, sometimes true, sometimes not, that are being leaked out of the intelligence community. We've had over 60 leaks in the first 6 months from the intelligence community, when the other administrations previous to us were in the single digits after the entire time. This is a real problem. There are people that are putting our national security at risk. And I think that is one of the most undertold stories so far in the first 6 months of this administration. There's a ton of focus on what I like to call Russia fever, which is a total made-up story about the president trying to take away the legitimacy of his victory in November. And we need to focus on these leaks. This is the only illegal thing that has taken place.
Sarah, as you
know, it's a real serious problem.
As you know, part of what feeds the fever is the fact that the president and his associates have not been straight about exactly what happened. In fact, the attorney general himself first said he never had a meeting with Russians. He revised that. Then he said he never talked about the campaign. Now you have this new intercept that says he did indeed talk about the campaign. I know you're upset about the leak, but if it is indeed true, is that okay with the president that the attorney general was discussing the campaign with the Russian ambassador?
Again, I'm not going to comment on alleged illegal leak. I'm not going to get into the back and forth on that. I think if we're going to talk about issues with Russia, And I think that we certainly should. One of the first places we should look is at the $500,000 that Bill Clinton took from Russians while Hillary Clinton was the Secretary of State. If we want to talk about collusion, I think that's one of the first places we should look. They should ask for that money back. And I think that's where this focus should be. The media loves to talk about it only when it comes to President Trump. And they've been doing it for almost a year. They've come up with nothing when there's real issues, I think, with some of the activities that the Democrats took place in.
Sarah, in fact, you know that's not true. You know that for many months, you and the president and his team denied any contacts with the Russians. Just in the last couple of weeks, we've seen those contacts revealed. That's why Don Jr. is going to have to appear before the Senate. That's why Jared Kushner is appearing before the Senate this week as well. This is not a made-up story from the press, but I do want to focus in on the attorney general right here as well, because you've said the president has confidence in the attorney general, yet in that interview with the New York Times, he says he wouldn't have appointed him, that he was unfair. I just don't understand how you reconcile those two statements.
Look, the president knows that the attorney general is trying hard, and he appreciates that. But at the same time, he's disappointed that he chose to recuse himself. I don't think that that's inconsistent or hard to understand that there would be frustration with that.
And the president is still frustrated?
Certainly. But I think, again, he's mostly frustrated with the